now. From Plaza Gardens, deep in the heart of Disneyland, in Anaheim, California, we present Big Bands at Disneyland. A celebration of big band music, featuring the best of the big bands in concert. Tonight, starring Woody Herman and the Young Thundering Herd. Ladies and gentlemen, your host for Big Bands at Disneyland, Peter Marshall.
Oh, yeah! Hear that steady blue flame chugging underneath my voice? That blue flame, the theme song of Woody Herman's Young Thundering Herd. His way and our way of welcoming you to the Magic Kingdom. Welcome to Plaza Gardens in Disneyland, where once again we capture the romance and excitement of America's favorite big bands. Ladies and gentlemen, Woody Herman and the Young Thundering Herd.
Thank you. It's lovely to be here to play for you. Things ain't what they used to be. One, two, three.
Thank you.
Here's one that is recently put into the Hall of Fame on the Grammy Awards show. It's a good old good one that features the sound of the saxophones, and it's called The Four Brothers. This is Vintage of 1949, and it's Ralph Burns' composition, Early Autumn. is Brad Williams at the piano. Early autumn, Frank Tiberi's saxophonist. Frank Tiberi.
What makes a recording a smash hit? Well, it's one of those mysteries that will never, ever be explained. But back in 1939, while trying to live up to its name, the band that plays the blues, Woody Herman and his band recorded a simple blues riff called Woodchopper's Ball. It swept the country, won a gold record. Still remains Woody Herman's most requested instrumental. Here it is again, remarkably fresh, Woodchopper's Ball.
Yeah. Williams at the piano. Now we're going to hear some bass. Bassist is a great American. His name is John Adams. You remember him? John, I do.
You know, reputations have a way of spreading rapidly in the music business. It doesn't take long before a band leader's strong points or weak points are known not only by his own band, but by musicians with other orchestras. Ask any sideman whether they played for him or not. Woody Herman has always been the greatest leader in terms of work conditions. Whenever Herman alumni gather, there may be differences of opinion about his clarinet playing or his singing, but there is never disagreement on the human factor. Woody Herman was and still is the warmest leader in the business. And it's encouraging to know that nice guys can finish first. But we're not here to discuss finishing, especially since Woody Herman shows no inclination to slow down, even after half a century as a leader. Now, we've called this meeting to dig into the past, to how and where Woodrow Charles Herman began. The Milwaukee native was dancing in local theaters, believe it or not, at age 6, and 3 years later began playing sax. He played with a number of bands in the 30s, and the most important being Isham Jones from 1934 through 1936. Now, when the Isham Jones band broke up, Woody took its key men and formed a cooperative band and quickly earned a reputation for being the band that plays the blues. Now, the first couple of years were anything but spectacular, but in 1939, he recorded Woodchopper's Ball. It eventually sold 1 million copies, and from that point on, Woody Herman was meant to be heard. Only in his case, herd was spelled H-E-R-D. Woody has had a number of thundering herds, and they have recorded a number of memorable hits. Caledonia, Northwest Passage, Summer Sequence, Apple Honey, Happiness is Just a Thing Called Joe with Francis Wayne, wow. Goosey Gander and Your Father's Mustache. They also boasted some of the greatest names in jazzdom, from Stan Getz and Zoot Sims to Milt Jackson and Chubby Jackson. He even had Dizzy Gillespie for 1 week, and he remembers advising Dizzy to stick to writing and give up the trumpet. That wasn't the only time Woody passed up a golden opportunity. Around 1940, when he was looking for a new girl singer, he heard one that had been recommended, but for reasons known only to Woody, he failed to choose, of all people, Dinah Shore. Obviously, Mr. Herman has made more right decisions than wrong ones down through the years. You see, Woody is one of the survivors. He has found the fountain of youth. He's as young, as vital, as curious, and as swinging as his herdsman, and just as thunderous.
did like the last note of Fried McGriddle. Thank you. Miller. 1, 2, 3. trumpet. There are gray skies. I don't mind the gray skies. You make them blue, sunny boy. Friends may forsake me. Let them all forsake me. You pull me through, sunny boy. You came from heaven, and I know your worth, 'cause you made a heaven
for me right here on earth. And when I'm old and gray, dear, promise you won't stray, dear. I love you so, sunny boy. You're sent from heaven, and I know your worth, 'cause you've made a heaven for me right here on earth. And when I'm old and gray, dear, promise you won't stray, dear. I'll miss you so, sunny boy. Yeah, I love you, my sunny boy. When I'm old and gray, I'll miss you so, sunny boy. Yeah, I need you, love you, sunny boy. That's the way that was.
Woody and I had a chance to chat about his music and his new young thundering herd, and I'd like to share a few moments of our conversation with you earlier today. As long as I can remember, there's always been the Woody Herman herd. What year did you start the band, Woody?
Actually, we started in 1936, and we were the remnants of what had been a Nash and Jones band, a great band. And five of us stayed together and then hired other people, and we had our first engagement in New York at Roseland Bowl.
That was the big ballroom then, I guess.
Yeah, it was pretty great.
Sure. I've always noticed, though, you've had young musicians, even in the old days. Why?
Well, for one thing, I think you need youth because you have to have energy in my kind of music. And I've never considered myself a band leader, for one thing. I think I'm a pretty good coach. And consequently, I've always felt that just as in sports, you need youth to accomplish what I want to accomplish.
A lot of the universities today have young bands, like Texas State and Eastman.
Oh, yes.
And what do you do? Do you hear about these musicians, or do you go to these schools?
Well, I have a system that seems to work for us, and we very rarely ever have to send anyone back. I go to the members of my own band and into the sections where we may be needing someone, and they make suggestions, and we all have an understanding that we don't want to send players back. So you have to give it a lot of thought and be very sure of whom you are recommending.
Which leads me to the next question. Well, what has been the biggest headache in keeping a band together?
Oh, probably the financial end of it, you know, because that's an up and down thing. For about the last, maybe 20 years, I have learned to consider it a hobby. It's really no longer a business.
And so what would you say is the biggest pleasure is just having this as like an avocation and you're loving it so
well,
much?
Well, that, and I still love music with desperation. So consequently, it's what I do best, and I'd rather be out here somewhere in the world playing some music. ¶¶ However, I would not advise you to try to dance to this because we don't carry much insurance. But I'd like to play it for you. It's a good old good one called Caledonia. What make your big head so hard? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Baby's great big teeth, long lean blanket, nothing to eat. She's my baby lover, just the same. Crazy about that woman. Caledonia, Caledonia, what make your big head so tall? Love you just the same. Caledonia, Caledonia, what make your big head so that's Frank Tiberian, Jennifer. Mark Lewis. Oh, yeah, baby. My man, Big John. We'll be right back.
notice his fingers never leave his hands. It's very fast. It's John Adams on bass, John Adams.
That blue flame is smoldering again, but regretfully it means we must take our leave of the great Woody Herman Orchestra. There can be no regrets in realizing that the big band sounds of the Thundering Herd will continue uninterrupted, because that's the way Woody Herman stays young. Next week, another great band direct from Plaza Garden as the Disney Channel continues its exciting celebration of big bands at Disneyland. Peter Marshall saying good night. Thank you, Woody. Thank you, Herb.
Good night.